Welcome to this Made for Success Studios production of Bod Behavior by Isabel Chiara, read by Sabra May. Copyright 2021, all rights reserved. For my family, who gave me the opportunity to get to know and to grow the parts of myself I'd kept hidden. For my sister, who, through thick and thin, has navigated life alongside me, and how as a combined force we can improve any situation, leaving no stone unturned. For my brother, who keeps me in check, and has helped me refine my sense of determination. For my mom, who prioritized family structure no matter what, and strengthened the foundation that supported each of us to spread our wings. For my dad, whose just-go-for-it mindset modeled to me how to move forward into the unknown courageously and ultimately to trust myself. For my nieces and nephews, who I love as much as life itself. And finally, to writing books, and how doing so gave me the heart to more deeply know and appreciate my family in many ways. Author's note: Who is Giana Giovanni? Giana Giovanni was, at first, a proxy protagonist. I believe I crafted her to bear the vulnerability of the subject matter in Eat Your Words, my first book. See, developing Giana, or Gigi as she's often called, permitted me to safely explore a storyline I'd known well, a woman's lifelong struggle with food fixation and eating overwhelm. Where I'd found it challenging to muster this tale from an Isabella Chiara first-person perspective, conjuring Giana opened lyrical doors within me. Silent tissues came alive. Parts of my life emoted, transformed, and healed. Somewhere mid-scribing Eat Your Words, the fuller extent of Giana dawned on me. She wasn't simply a way to keep my name undercover while I examined the psychological underpinnings of a woman who'd endured decades of diet industry trends. No. Giana was a bridge. Her story expressed the calling of many women to gain deeper residency in our physical bodies. This felt residency countered what psychology might term a dissociative state, which means to operate oneself detached from sense of body or emotion. Rather, we wanted reassociation, and Giana had come through me, specifically, to summon such a request. As I approached my second publication, Bod Behavior, I knew that Giana would again be central to the plot, and that her voyage would serve to symbolize ours. As Giana set the roadmap, I knew I would work in parallel alongside her, equally seeking what she was seeking on this writing quest. It became mandatory then to work toward awakening the dormant parts of myself and, like Giana, explore my own bod behaviors, the mechanics of how my body feels, reacts, processes, and allows life to permeate me. In the pages ahead, we'll venture through narrative episodes starring Giana, as well as interviews with experts in the world of embodied wisdoms, including cognitive behaviorists, medical doctors, dietitians, body-based therapists, scholars, and more. These learned leaders graciously gave their time and conversation to help me better unpack the word behavior. Additionally, within Bod Behavior, you'll encounter processes or meditative introspective practices woven right into the book's flow, provided as opportunities for the reader to embark on their own inner quest alongside Giana. Because I've personally learned that self-transformation is not a spectator sport, I wanted to encourage your active participation within this story. As we do for any journey, we must prepare the necessary gear for our road ahead. To be candid, it's not always easy to maintain motivation for the self-explorative, transformational trek. So, how do we best outfit ourselves to stay continually committed along the terrain? It's simply by being together, in alliance for our utmost physical freedom, that we reinforce our stance here. The readiness we have as women to willingly listen to our own body wisdom and to conjure our collective, most empowered presence. And when we ask,
we hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.